各位，单车道路上行驶的速度大概每小时30公里，只是慢过汽车行世界的限制车速少少。不过有人仲想步单车去得更快，咁原来单靠物理学，人力踩单车可以达到时速140公里噶。另外，今日仲要介绍传入加拿大冇几耐新奇有趣的泡泡足球。咁依家先讲下醒目鞋毡。GPS 全球卫星定位系统的发明，带嚟生活上多种方便。靠它来找路、找失物、寻人，通通用得着。但现在有人将 GPS 借入鞋尖，帮助找回走失了的失智症病人。虽然 GPS 同样可以放在其他物件上，但是出街着鞋机会最大，似乎最有效。不过醒目鞋尖实用之余，就带来私隐问题了，会不会被利用为监察别人行踪的工具呢？梁嘉怡报道。
两个几星期前，安省黄市一个82岁婆婆患有失智症中的认知障碍症，夜深时分在屋企人不知道的情况下，独自由屋企步行好几公里到400号公路上，凌晨4点几被车撞死于公路中。失智症患者走失、发生意外的事件屡见不鲜，最近老婆婆的不幸意外更加将成为嚟紧9月21号世界认知障碍症日，世界卫生组织与渥太华举行的失智症会议中关注的议题，如何协助失智症及其家人减低一位患者的病症带来的意外风险。根据去年的世界认知障碍症报告指，60%失智症患者会有一次走失的意外，走失3次的失智症患者大约占70%。而失智症人士游荡迷路，未能于24小时被找回，有46%将可能死亡。以往为了方便追踪同辨认患者，失智症人士可能会戴上有个人资料同病况的手带或者是颈链，携带有全球卫星定位系统 GPS 的追踪器或者是手提电话，或者着住安装了来自 GPS 的一双鞋。最近于美国研发及试验，将于9月推出加拿大市场的智能鞋垫，可以作为追踪失智症患者的另一种工具选择。将智能鞋垫放入任何一对失智症患者喜欢着的鞋，就算他不记得带手带或者追踪器，都有一对摄咗入鞋笼内的 GPS 鞋垫追踪到患者。这款外表同一般鞋尖无异，厚度5至6毫米，防少量雨水但不可以浸水的智能鞋尖，是靠内置的 SIM 卡、GPS 系统及电池与电脑网页或者智能电话的 App 就可以即时追踪到鞋尖用者。
I hit locate. For instance, I wanted to see where the person was for the last 3 hours. Okay, and I kind of come out this way. I'm learning here, and it shows me coming all the way up. Now, each one of these points, I can click on it, and it'll actually tell me that I was doing 39 kilometers an hour, an approximate address, latitude and longitude.
追踪智能鞋垫用者的人可以在电脑系统上预设一个 geofence 地区围墙，设定患者一般在地图内的某个范围活动。万一患者走出预设的围墙，家人可以获得即时通知，减低患者走失的风险。
And I can make it really detailed. Okay, it doesn't have to be circular. Then what I would do is actually go into the notifications and say, okay, who needs to be notified if they leave or enter that area? So all I would do is take the email address. I can add 20 of those. 95% of the time, we want 24/7 notifications.
So you remember the geofence, the area that we drew on the software, appears right onto my smartphone, and you can see where I've actually exited the area right in that particular environment, right there. So this came right to my smartphone, and it can also come in a text message as well.
似乎智能鞋尖的用量，一般经过几两个钟的再充电，可以用上2至5日不等。这种在2011年被展出于瑞典科技博物馆，成为当年100项世界重要发明之一的产品。它可追踪的地理覆盖面和手提电话差不多，可以遍布全球。只要当产品进军某个国家市场，和当地的通讯设备公司合作，取得网络覆盖合作计划就得。因此，用户购买服务的形式和用手提电话相似。先以大约320元加元购买一对智能鞋垫，然后每月以大约40元加币月费购买即时追踪数据。当要出国去第二个国家，再购买类似漫游的服务计划，在第二个国家同样都获得行踪数据。 同一般 GPS 的系统一样，它的数据准确程度大约是 95%。现时美国已经有智能鞋垫出售，不少失智症患者、脑受创人士或者自闭症儿童都尝试采用。有医学界人士虽然对新科技表示欢迎，但就说仍然要尊重用者的意愿、感受和私隐。
如果一些这样的 device 就是最有效的，但是就同时呢亦都要考慮翻病人的感受咯，即係佢想唔想用啊？係咪好 invade to 佢哋嘅 privacy 啊？然後 way 俾人跟蹤，咁想佢哋究竟想唔想咧？咁個病人可能有病，認知上有啲障礙，但係情緒都如果即係都喺度嘅，都要顧及翻佢哋嘅情緒咯。係咯，或者盡量 talk about 呢啲嘢早啲。早啲，當佢哋仲係即係可以明白啊嘅時候，盡量作出啲決定，盡量 involve 個病人嘅 decision。或者 at 邊個 point 你會覺得我哋可以試下呢啲嘢啊，因為你安全嘅著想。
全球有3500万人患上認知障礙症，預計到咗2050年，患者人數會遞增至2亿7700万人。在本國目前就有747000个認知障礙症患者，佔了全國失智症病人總數1/3。17年之後，患者人數將上升1倍。國家花費在治療失智症人士上，一年就用上330亿加元。呢種因為年紀大而引起腦退化失智病，造成腦認知、記憶同語言功能減退。現時年輕至40-50岁都開始患病。越来越多病人家属向医生询问科技如何可以在治疗和日常生活上帮到失智症患者。
Caregivers are becoming more sophisticated. They are looking into more of these technologies. Also, technologies, some kind of tablet computer that allows you to play games. Some of the technology that's helping us to diagnose and follow individuals has to do withHuge developments in neuroimaging, which allow us now to see the pathology of Alzheimer's disease actually in the brain of people who are still alive. Technology in the sense of using telecommunication devices, soles of your shoes, wearing GPS systems on your belt, a lot more of home-based technologies in terms of even giving people advice by computer or getting training to be better in their cognitive function. The use of technology to help people remember things. This is SenseCam, it was called, and people wore it when they went on excursions or had events, passively recording in pictures what was happening to them. It could be made into a story or quickly put together in a sequence so that they could remember that event.
医学界多年来一直敦促本国政府，除了科技以外，应该效法英国、美国、法国、澳洲等，设立一个全国的失智症计划，让专家研究和了解失智症更多的风险因素，从而作出预防并找出治疗的方法。
That would bring researchers, providers, people from the academic world, industry, people with the disease and their families to come together and actually help to develop a plan and implement a plan with clear goals and targets to achieve key components to increase the amount of money going to research. That's really critical. Secondly, to offer standards for training of people who are delivering care for people with dementia.Thirdly, to be able to support caregivers in helping to be able to take care of their family members with the disease, and also to provide public awareness and education about the disease to encourage people to seek help. But also,
在政府未有进一步的长远计划，而科技又不可以令病况好转的时候，患者家人应该考虑其他策略。
一個 function 如果冇咗嘅話咧，好唔 likely 可以即係有翻噶啦。要 realistic 同埋要採取多樣嘅措施之餘咧，亦都要 balance between 病人嘅 independence 同埋佢 safety 咯。如果真係到了一個地步，屋企人或者屋企唔再係 safe for 個 patient 嘅話咧，都要考慮一啲長期護理嘅設施啊，或者 home help 啊。